off by saying how embarrassed and ashamed I am for disappointing my family, my teammates, my coaches, and the entire UCLA community. I feel terrible, and I'm sorry to everybody who I let down. With that being said, I take full responsibility for the mistake I have made, shoplifting. I know that this goes beyond me letting my school down, but I let the entire country down. Before I thank everybody who worked so incredibly hard to help us return home safely, I want to thank the Chinese police and the government for taking care of us and treating us well during our time there. To President Trump and the United States government, thank you for taking the time to intervene on our behalf. We really appreciate you helping us out. Thank you to all the Pac-12 representatives for all of your time and support. Thank you, Dan Guerrero, for sticking by our side and doing whatever you could to help us through this. Thank you, Chris Carlson, for taking the time out of your schedule to stay with us the entire time and guide us every step of the way. To Doug Harrison, thank you for also staying with us and giving us guidance with everything. To my teammates, thank you for being there for us throughout the process. You guys mean so much to me. To Coach Alford, Coach Tyus, Coach Bussard, Coach Grace, thank you for all your support. You guys have always believed in me, not only as a basketball player, but also as a person. I'm sorry for letting you down. Lastly, to my family, my mom and dad, you guys have raised me to be smart and always make the right choices. You never left my side, and it hurts me the most that I disappointed and embarrassed you. To my younger brother, Ben, this is not the example that I want to set for you. But from here on out, I promise that I will be the best role model I can be to look up for you to look up to. I've been looking forward to being at UCLA growing since I was young. The alumni here have set such a high standard for both academically and athletically. And as a UCLA student athlete, I'm disappointed in myself that I failed to live up to that. I can only hope that my actions, my words, my hard work in the weeks to come will prove to my coaches, my teammates, and our fans that I am more capable of meeting that high standard. Away from the court, I'll work especially hard in the classroom to show that I can be an outstanding representative of this incredible university, a place that is so important to many people around the world. Again, thank you to everybody who has been there and expressed concerns for me and my safety this past week. I can assure you that I will never do anything again to jeopardize UCLA's reputation and as my own. Go Bruins. Thank you.
I'd like to start off by saying sorry for stealing from the stores in China. I didn't exercise my best judgment, and I was wrong for that. I apologize to my family, my coaches, my teammates, and UCLA for letting so many people down. I also apologize to the people of China for causing them so much trouble. I'm a young man, however, it's not an excuse for making a really stupid decision. I don't feel sorry for myself, and I've learned my lesson from this big mistake, and I'm 110% sure that I'll not make a bad decision like this one again. I also like everyone to know that this does not define who I am. My family raised me better than that, and I'm gonna make myself a better person from here on out. I have the utmost respect for the Chinese Police Department as well, and I'd like to thank them for treating me so respectfully, even after I made a stupid decision. I'd like to thank Chris Carlson and Doug Erickson for staying with us and just helping us out while we were in China and taking care of them. I'm grateful for the UCLA team that stood strong beside us and made it possible for me to be sitting here in front of you all today. I respect and admire all the hard work that they put in to get us back to the United States. I'd also like to thank President Trump and the United States government for the help that they provided as well. I'm grateful to be back home and I'll never make a mistake like this again. I'm extremely sorry for those who I let down, but I'm also very thankful for all the help, love, and support that they provided. And I take full responsibility for my actions, and I'm sorry. Thank you.
Thank you, Lane.
First off, I would like to apologize to all the fans who support you so late, because I feel like my actions have hurt them the most. It hurts me because I can see the pain that I caused them. I apologize to my teammates, my coaches, and my family because of how much negative attention that I've put on them that they do not deserve. Sorry for shoplifting. What I did was stupid. There's just no other way to put it, and I'm not that type of person. I hope that this mistake will not define me as a person, but it shows that I've messed up and can learn from it. I don't want to be known for this dumb mistake. I want to be known for my respectfulness and my love and passion for the game of basketball. This event has taught me a lot, and it has changed me in a way that I can't explain. I have so much more respect for the people around me, from our coaches and staff to the fans who live for UCLA. I have also strengthened my relationship with God throughout this time. Without Him, I would be nothing. To all the fans out there watching, I hope that you can forgive me. I hope that you can forgive my stupid, childish actions. I have learned my lesson, and I hope that I can earn back the love and support that our passionate fans bring to this program. I would like to thank everyone involved in this whole ordeal. Thank you to Chris, Doug, Gloria, and Jerry for staying with us the whole time. Thank you to the police department, which treated us very well. Thank you to the Pac-12 and the whole UCLA community that helped us the whole way. And thank you to the United States government and President Trump for your efforts to bring us home.
Thank you, gentlemen. You guys are excused.
First of all, I'd like to acknowledge that there's been significant public and media interest in the situation in China. And I want to thank everyone here for respecting that we cannot say much over the past week. Our priority throughout this entire situation was making sure that Jello, Jalen, and Cody got home safely. And we were informed that anything that's said during the process could have jeopardized a successful return to Los Angeles. We are grateful that they've safely returned home and have been able to reconnect with their family, their friends, and their teammates. I can't thank enough the incredible folks here at UCLA, at the Pac-12, and even President Trump and his administration for the nonstop efforts to resolve this situation. To say that our young men are incredibly fortunate to have this kind of support system that's around them is certainly an understatement. From the UCLA Office of Legal Affairs, to Chancellor Block, to Dan Guerrero, from our senior staff in athletics, Chris Carlson, Doug Erickson, Dwayne Broussard, my entire staff, and others on the ground with us in China, this was truly been a team effort. Everyone focused on the best interest of our young men. I especially want to recognize Chris for an unbelievable commitment for him to stay with our guys, Gloria Navarez from our Pac-12 conference, who was just simply incredible throughout everything. As a coach, you recruit these young men for a long time, and you get to know them very, very well during the process. These are good young men who have exercised an inexcusable lapse of judgment. And now they have to live with that. They let a lot of people down in the process. I'm extremely disappointed in their actions. You just heard them apologize. I would like to again apologize on their behalf to the Chancellor, to Dan, to the Bruin family. These young men are going to have to prove their words and actions that this isn't who they are, and that they will not let their identity be defined by this incident. I know Jello, Cody, and Jalen well, and I'm confident that they have already begun to use this experience as a life lesson. They're going to have to regain the trust of this athletic department, of this university, and because this was such a high-profile international matter, the trust of the general public. Trust is earned, it isn't just given. These three young men will remain suspended indefinitely from our program as we work through the review process with the university's Office of Student Conduct. During that indefinite suspension, they will not travel with the team, nor will they suit up for home games. At some point, they may be permitted to join team workouts, practices, and meetings, but that timeline has yet to be determined. They will have to earn their way back. They will cooperate fully with the university review of this matter, and will use this time to focus on their academics. My expectation is that they will work hard to demonstrate why they deserve to be a part of this program. I'd also like to express my gratitude to the other young men in our program who represented UCLA the right way during our trip and were able to put aside the distractions of travel, learning, and enjoying a foreign country, while also defeating a very good Georgia Tech basketball team. The experience was memorable, and the Chinese people were such gracious hosts everywhere that we went. As the head coach of our program, it's my responsibility to move us forward, and we'll do just that by focusing on basketball and the young men suiting up tonight against Central Arkansas. Thank you.
Thank you, Steve. And finally, we have UCLA Athletic Director Dan Guerrero.
Thank you. As Steve mentioned, we're very disappointed in the conduct of our three student athletes. On what should have been a very positive, memorable trip for our entire team and for our university, their irresponsible actions overshadow that opportunity. They've taken the first step here today, as you've seen, apologizing for the hurt and pain that they've caused the UCLA community and accepting full responsibility. In my meeting with them in Hangzhou, their expression of remorse, regret, sadness, and embarrassment was as genuine as it gets. They know they made a huge mistake, and as you can see, they're deeply sorry for it. To echo Steve, it's my hope that these three young men are not defined by this one instance, but rather by their efforts to restore our trust in them. Their actions in China are contrary to our true blue and values in UCLA athletics, and quite frankly, are unacceptable. As a young man in Steve's knowledge, there were so many people at UCLA, both in Westwood and in China, as well as the Pac-12 conference, who were instrumental in getting us through this challenging time. Let me just express my gratitude to everyone involved. I also want to add my sincere thanks to Chancellor Block for his resolute support throughout, as well as to acknowledge the efforts of President Trump and his administration, including White House Chief of Staff General Kelly, who took the time to call our students over the weekend. I also want to express my sincere apology to Alibaba and the Pac-12 Conference, who worked collaboratively to make this incredible cultural exchange possible, the wonderful people of China, Georgia Tech, and our UCLA community for the disruption and the negative attention the students' actions brought upon this extraordinary trip. I recognize there are many questions yet to be answered about what transpired in China over the last 9 days, and I appreciate the media and the job that you have to do. My statement today will provide some answers to those questions, though not likely all of them. While the students having just returned last night, we're continuing to review certain aspects of the matter. Some fans, alumni, and members of the media have wondered why we remained silent during this situation. Essentially, as you might imagine, and it was indicated by Steve, the sensitive nature of trying to bring our students home safely demanded that we stay silent. Let me start now by saying that prior to leaving the United States and again while in China, Coach Alford met with the team and reminded them all of the expectations and the responsibilities that go along with representing UCLA. He and his staff did this as a means, proactively, to try to prevent a negative situation of any kind. On Monday, November 6th, first full day of the trip, the group had a phenomenal experience visiting the Alibaba campus, where the team had an opportunity to tour the campus and to hear from Joe Tsai, the co-founder and executive vice chairman of the Alibaba Group. Later that evening, the students were given 90 minutes of free time, if you will, to explore the town of Hangzhou or simply to relax. Jello, Jalen, and Cody used that time to visit several stores that were adjacent to the hotel. It was at that time that they took the items from three of those stores without paying for them. They then returned to the team hotel with those items. The following morning, November 7th, the police arrived at the team hotel and began to interview several members of the Georgia Tech team and the UCLA basketball team, as they attempted to identify which students were involved in the thefts. In addition to interviewing several students, police also searched bags, both in the hotel and on the team bus. Within a few hours, they identified Jello, Jalen, and Cody as the likely suspects and escorted them to a local police station. Associate head coach Dwayne Broussard, Pac-12 associate commissioner Gloria Navarez were able to go with him, and Steve Alford and associate athletic director Chris Carlson followed shortly thereafter. I was notified by the arrest of our UCLA personnel on the ground while I was mid-flight to Shanghai. The chancellor, the UCLA Office of Legal Affairs, and other appropriate university personnel and UC administrators were quickly brought into the loop, which began work on securing both legal counsel and information, which at that time, of course, was rather sparse. Following the arrest, the students remained in custody, undergoing questioning by police, before being released on bail early in the morning of November 8th. The total bail amount was approximately $2,200. As part of the conditions of the release, the students had to surrender their passports and agree to travel restrictions. They were not required to remain in the hotel, though we made that decision out of abundance of caution and respect for the process. The bail in question has since been refunded by the Chinese authorities. The UCLA Office of Legal Affairs, in concert with the Pac-12 Conference and legal experts in China, worked to identify local outside counsel in Hangzhou to represent the three student athletes. The university then requested and subsequently received authorization from the parents of the students to engage legal representation on their behalf. Regarding the issue of the expenses that were incurred over the last 9 days, UCLA provided the necessary resources to secure the timely release and safe return of the student athletes. We now have the task of working to reconcile who's ultimately responsible for the costs incurred, in addition to addressing any NCAA implications. When the rest of the team departed for Shanghai to continue their trip in preparation for the game against Georgia Tech, Chris Carlson and Gloria Navarro stayed behind in Hangzhou with the three students. Over the ensuing days, our staff and students fully cooperated with the local authorities, who were gracious throughout the entire matter, in an attempt, obviously, to resolve the situation. I made a visit to the hotel on Friday to check on everyone and to reassure the students that many people were working on their behalf and doing everything possible to try to get them home. From those meetings, I was confident that the students were safe and being treated with the highest level of respect. On Saturday, when the rest of the team and the traveling party returned home, two UCLA administrative staff members, Associate Athletic Director Chris Carlson and Doug Erickson, remained in China with the student athletes. We left with the belief that substantial progress was being made to achieve a satisfactory outcome. To that end, on Tuesday in Shanghai, the local authorities confirmed that the student athletes could leave the country. They did so at 9 p.m. Shanghai time, 5 a.m. Pacific time on Tuesday, and of course arrived last night at LAX around 5 p.m. When the charges against the students were ultimately withdrawn, Jalen Cody and Jello, of course, did admit to breaking the law. As Steve noted, the three student athletes have been suspended indefinitely from the men's basketball program as we continue to review the matter in collaboration with the Office of Student Conduct, as we do with all cases related to misconduct for students. We will work together and prudently come to some resolution on this matter in short order. I know there are still questions to be answered. It is my hope that in the coming weeks, as we learn more, we'll be able to share additional information with all of you. As difficult as this time period has been for all of us who love UCLA so dearly, I'm confident in the resiliency of the UCLA community and the Bruin family, and we will continue to move forward together. Thank you.
Thank you, Dan. Steven.